D&D Saturday morning on Epic Table. Welcome.
Welcome. You know what? Okay, it's going to have the wrong title, but you know what, heck. All right. It does say Titanfall, though. It does say Titanfall, a Pathfinder epic, which is what I've been titling this, and it just has the wrong date. We'll fix that. It auto-saves after I'm done with this anyways. So, welcome everybody that is on Ustream, Hitbox, Twitch, and
YouTube.
Instagib and YouTube.
Instagib is still alive, I'm surprised.
I'm not, actually.
I'm broadcasting to five places at once. Of course, Twitch and Ustream and Hitbox are not connecting currently.
At least, what was that? What was that one we used to go on? Like, Tad moved from Twitch to the
Endgame.
Endgame.
Endgame no longer exists.
Exactly. My point exactly.
Actually,
it stopped existing a long time ago.
Oh, thank you very much for the host, Dave.
Oh, shit. That means I'm not. That's why. Okay, sorry. again. I am the one who's blowing it tonight. God.
Dave.
Hosting you is not what I want to be doing. Sorry, Ron. I need to turn off my hosting. Okay, that's why I'm not on Twitch yet. Okay. Oh,
fine, Dave. You don't love me anymore.
You do not do this for 3 weeks, and you forget everything. What is going on?
Also, well, you got to admit, though, you also had the little bit of a stress of moving to a different...
The job... Yeah, the job has turned out to be a mental stress point. You know what?
Yeah, because you're dealing with stressed people who don't always...
Yeah.
Oh, trust me, Dave, I know...
You did phone service, right?
I've done customer service for 8 years, and it's not fun.
I've dealt with transmission people.
Yeah, I dealt with people.
I think another time you were working for the insurance.
I dealt before I got the 6 months. Well, it's time for you to get your benefits out.
Yeah.
So we can make sure you follow and we can fire you.
I have an advertisement for Proactive Shave Club currently playing on my channel. It also still thinks that I am on my channel. I'm playing Marvel Heroes. Thanks.
Oh, just hit refresh. You'll be fine.
Okay, yeah. The new Geico commercial it's right up there with the State Farm Mayhem commercial.
Okay, let's start!
Yeah! We only have an hour left to play. We're almost to that point, as it stands.
Yeah, I know.
The thing is that it doesn't take me long anymore to learn the new songs that we do every week. So, I mean, if I'm like a little late,
We'd be fine.
Yep.
Okay.
We start at 9. All right.
Well, our problem this week was everybody is getting Epic Table set up, so.
Mm-hmm. Well, we are. I mean, we'll be fine.
Okay.
Make one quick adjustment. We have our lovely bunch of adventurers. Our lovely bunch of time we were on this game before I, you know, had problems and everything. We were leaving the town reluctantly with the party in some cases.
Yes.
I'm not reluctant.
In most cases.
And you are going to travel to the port and to go across the Entor Sea to the land of Entor.
Perfect.
Because you were told, and you were told a individual, or I should say, you were told there was an item there you need to start helping in your quest.
Yes.
I had to drag this again, sorry. Alright.
What, drag what?
Okay. The initiative so I can see it. It's not quite the right spot for me to see. Okay.
Oh, yeah, it did affect me. I have it locked in place.
Yep. Okay. So, your band of merry adventurers need to travel. Basically, the amount of time it will take you to travel to get to the port is 2 days. Not doesn't seem like much, does it?
No.
Surprisingly, how close things are.
So we're not going to where the bard is at. We're just going to go to the nearest port by ship ticket.
Yes.
All right, I'm fine with that.
Mm-hmm. No, the bard is going far, far, far further south.
Yeah, to Portsmouth.
Mm-hmm.
If I remember the name of the city correctly.
You are correct. You do remember. All right.
Sorry. I'm adjusting it myself. Sorry. That's why you lock it into place when you get it in the position you want.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Red. So you are headed down the road between Alston, which is where you guys were, and the town of Penwith.
Can you make that map a separate tab so we could view it as well?
Why? Perhaps I can.
Because we have the world map. And that's it. We can't see the town.
We have the local travel map. Now we've got a big blank map. Wonderful. Everything's broken forever. Good job.
Smart ass. You didn't think I had it. All right.
There we go.
There we go. So, currently we are where?
Alston is... Where's my drawing tools? Do you remember drawing tools? Now we get to play around with this stuff. I want my pen. Oh, give me a circle, guys. Come on. Oh, you know what? Hey, a while later. Oh, I'm right over here.
Hey! I see. Dave, why didn't you just pen circle?
I didn't see it.
It's right beside the select.
Oh.
You also have dip.
I know. I went for the yellow. Okay. Right. somebody's dog's going nuts. By the way, I live in an apartment. I want to point out, I live in an apartment that has no animals. I have now seen 3 cats, 4 dogs, and a boa constrictor.
Oh, that's like, no, sometimes no pet apartments will allow cats. I know because I lived in one and they allowed me to have a cat.
Mm-hmm.
So, but a dogs and boa constrictors,
The only reason I know it's a boa, I saw that he was cleaning the cage. Oh, by the way, he's the one that lives right next door to me, too. So, yeah, I'm real thrilled on that one.
Okay. Can you rename the map things? Like, the map tabs? Please.
What, you don't want map 1 and map 1?
No, please.
Can I get a name changer, please? Thank you. No, I cannot. Why does it allow me to change the name of the map? Oh.
You might have map options across the top.
Okay. Well, we'll figure this out. Like I said, I know I can normally do it.
Okay, well, let's just get going.
All right. We're going to go. We're going.
Hey, what happened to the map?
Readjusted everything on me. Woohoo! Good job. All right. Let's get this right. Okay. The joys of learning a new program, folks. All right. The trip between Alston and Penwith, and yeah, I'm still eating my pizza. Sorry.
Damn you, Dave. I want pizza, but I don't have money for it.
It was through the forest. Still part of that big forest that you guys were running through to get to Alston in the first place. However, like the Baron said, and the troglodyte army that is coming after you, seems to have stopped at the border for some reason.
Okay.
But because of the chaos and everything else, there are people that want to take advantage of it.
Take advantage of a situation? No. I wonder who that could be.
Does your character want another punch in the face?
Fine. I liked when he brought that up.
I don't know. Does your character want a sword in their gut?
My dragon wouldn't allow it.
What? Okay, is this 8, 8, 8, 8? Okay, there he is. And of course, 9. Yeah, this is why I like. Thank you, by the way, Ron, for providing this.
Not a problem.
Okay. Certain individuals of the ill repute have decided to take advantage of this situation and have blocked the road.
Oh, gee.
Oh, would you look at that? People who actually think they're important.
Three more, 2 men.
Yeah. Halt! To pass, you must pay the toll!
Wait, what happened? What happened?
We're in the sea.
You okay?
Ah! Where are we?
What is happening?
We're somewhere in the North Sea. Close to Iceland.
How did you guys get over on the other map? Get over on the other map.
Maps, Dave. None of us can do it, not to my knowledge.
Nope.
You're right over here, on mine.
Oh, we're out in the sea, on ours.
We're just on the world map. The other tab disappeared.
Yeah, they ceased to exist.
What?
Yeah.
Try sharing it again.
Try that. Share. You see it now?
No.
No. Oh, no.
You see it? You should only see one tab.
No, he's got the blank screen of death.
Titanfall, waiting for game organizer. Don't worry, what's game organizer? Oh, that might be just me.
No, it's...
Really?
Yeah. Guys, hey, it's a new program. What do you expect?
Yeah, it's true. All right.
Just add a new map. Delete the old one. Add a new one. I think if you highlight all of them, you could copy where the characters are, and then paste it on the other one.
It's because I bet you it's because of this name thing. Crap.
Okay, we'll wait. We'll take 20.
Ah, come on, quit hitting that. Map. New map. Shared map.
Yay.
Background image map. Background image.
Okay. We see it.
Yes, and I'm back on this map. Let's hope it doesn't disappear again.
Well, there's only one map now at the moment. Okay, add your guises while I add my guises.
For me, and most likely Dubs, you'll have to add us.
I could add mine.
And don't...
I can't add Dubs. Dubs has to add his.
Okay.
It won't let me.
I can drag?
Try it now, Dubs.
Dubs, right-click and remove the... Wait, you should be able to right-click and remove it from the player's screen there, and then try adding again.
Send portrait bar. Nope, that's not it.
Guys, please bear with us. This is a new program.
We're experimenting.
I don't understand why it does this. That's the one thing that's making me mad about this program.
Okay.
I can't get him on, Bron. Can you do it?
No. Dubs?
I can't get him on. I guess the game doesn't want him on.
No. Dubs, exit the game. Dave, you exit the game too, and then...
I can't, Ron. I'll cut everything. I'll kill everything if I leave.
No, if you leave the game, we will go to a screen saying waiting for a GM, basically. And then once you come back in, we will see everything again.
Alright. Give me a second, guys.
And Dubs, you have to leave too. And come back. Left. Okay.
You already left. Okay. Let me get the epic table back up.
Dubs, and you can join back in again now.
Welcome to fun, guys. Appreciate them.
Yep.
Oh, well.
We've had...
Cajun wings are in my future until this comes back up, so...
Where there's probably going to be no gameplay for a couple of weeks, the system gets figured out.
No, this is the only problem in playing, and I figured this was a quick... So you left, Dave?
Yeah.
Wow, it did it... Usually it cuts out when a person leaves. Okay, now, Dave, you should be able to add Dubs to the portrait bar.
I want to find his portrait because it resorted everything. I don't see his portrait up here.
Okay, then, Dubs, add yourself to the portrait bar.
Doing it.
Watch him now be able to do that. That'll be fun.
There we go. I'm in.
He's there.
Okay, there we go.
We're getting there. Damn it. We're going to get
it. Oh, Dave, do you have to readjust the squares?
I'm not worried about it.
No?
I'm not worried about it. I actually need to get my guys on. That's my thing. I'll just knock them back here further. I have plenty of room.
Well, yeah, I thought you said this was like a really long path. That's the only thing.
Well, I'll adjust it, but don't... It doesn't have to be... I want the... I can put everybody in there... And then I can adjust the...
Okay. Or you could just say each square is, like, a bigger distance or whatnot.
I'll be fine. Just...
Okay.
Let me get these last bunch. Okay, so we got 10 dudes on the field of battle.
Who needs Red Bull? Red Bull doesn't give you wings. Pizza Hut does.
Mm-hmm. Damn Skippy. All right.
So each is 5?
Yeah.
Okay.
By the way, we won't have to worry about... Champion scheme doesn't use grids anymore. So.
Adjusting the characters to get in.
Straight measurements, just ruler measurement.
This doesn't have ruler measurements, unfortunately.
Yeah, well, we can put it in. So, alright. I lost my initiative thing too. You know what? Not gonna worry about that.
Go ahead, Dave.
I'm not gonna worry about it. No, I'm not gonna worry about that. That was messing me up a little bit. So we'll deal with that later. I'm gonna do this the old fashioned one over here. Give me a sec. Notepad. The fucking thing.
Did it rename for everybody? Did the map rename for everybody?
What?
Did the map rename?
Yeah, travel map.
Yeah, Dave, rename is under actions and property.
Oh. Oh, there it is. Derp. I see it now in front of me, in front of my face.
Now let's hope it doesn't delete itself like the last two.
That's why I only got one up. All right.
Okay, so what was the guy say? The head guy saying?
Give me
pay
a second.
The toll.
Yeah, basically pay the toll.
What is the toll?
Why? Your money, of course.
I have not made any money. How can it be mine?
You have. And he stops. He starts talking and he stops. And he's looking at something.
What is he looking at?
Well, you know, there's a certain crystal thing over back there in the back.
Yeah. And Dan says, you see this dragon back here? It can shatter your bones into mush. And you will all die horrible, slow, meaningless deaths here. And I will laugh and rend all of your riches from your corpse. I'm actually going to do a bluff roll.
Well, go for it.
And my character, and Ixen is just sitting there, or standing there, shaking her head.
This is why it's cool to have a
drone. Oh, Dave, I really want to do something right now.
Yeah.
Or froth at the mouth, or froth.
And Dave will say, you have about 2 or 3 moments to run for your very life.
Dave, I have to do this.
Take those moments.
I have to do this, Dave.
Go ahead.
I don't know if Ixen realizes that a Dan is trying to keep them out of combat.
That came up quick, Ron.
Dave, there's a black screen on the stream.
Thank you. Oh, okay, thank you.
Thanks, Sass. He's the one who said it in the chat.
Oh, okay. They're seeing it now.
Where is my tools?
Yeah, tell
basic
me about
tools.
It.
Here's all the information, Dave.
Hold on. No, I'm not getting the screen on the cast. That's not one thing, it's another. Alright. You're not cooperating, we're going there.
Well, obvious to do that, obvious. Wait. 2 feet
got
per
it.
Level. 5, 10, 15. Yeah. My character will be moving up first, of course.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The bandit leader, the guy who's been talking. Turns to his fellow bandits. The Overking. Sorry, I'm chewing. The Overking has a bounty on dragon scales. Why don't we collect them, boys?
Okay, so then if you ignored what I put in chat, then I didn't cast it.
No, Ron.
Yeah?
You did.
Okay. Okay, so that means I have one less level one spell.
Alright. I want to point out something. You guys go to my channel. You don't see the chat room. Isn't that interesting?
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, it's a good thing, because you guys can't see the whispers. Alright. No screen sniping. Alright.
So we're
okay. So, all right, guys. We are 2 initiative, and I am going to roll my one.
You do
initiative.
Realize, Dave, that if Ixen uses spell, I have to use spell resistance.
You don't have. We're.
You said she has one less level one spell. All
right. And just a spell. Yeah.
Yes, I'm far too smart for my health.
No, wait a minute here. You got it. You got a point. You do have a point. What's your class level, dude?
My class level is, I've got 5 levels in Grove, 1 level in Bard. That's 6.
Yep, Ron, you need to roll. You do need to roll it.
Okay, I'll roll it to you. I'll roll it.
That's fine. That's fine.
I need to roll my spell resistance to that.
No, the spell resistance is Ron's roll. Then there's a possibility. There, let me look at this. There is a saving throw involved. Yes.
Roll 1d20.
You guys got me on that. You're right.
Yeah, because if he's playing a spell, Dane's natural spell resistance would immediately.
Okay. Okay. Roll a will save, then, Mr. Tobin.
Find my will.
By the way, you might want to program this one too.
Who, me?
I think that's plus 2, 20, d20 plus 2, right?
Yeah.
Alright. Program this in first.
It's the 3 saving throws is
yeah, I will do that later.
Yeah.
We'll save.
I'll tell you what there's gonna. I know what the difference is. Okay. Okay. Everything happens as I told. Okay.
Oh, nothing bad.
You don't know. Happens. You don't know.
Nothing bad happens that you can perceive. Alright. Okay, enough of messing around. Let's get on.
Okay.
Battle. I want to try a battle in this thing.
Okay, so I'll do my initiative to change that to everyone. Actually, let's see. I could have just a GM tab as well. You could have different tabs for different people.
Yep.
Hold on.
I forgot the sum, but I don't.
Okay, so dice roll, initiative.
Okay. Alright.
Oh, I didn't mean to just whisper to you. Why
That's
is
what the GM role is.
No. I meant that was supposed to be an everyone. Okay. Dave could attest to this. I got a 19 for initiative.
Yep. He's got a 19. I agree.
Picks or didn't happen.
Well, I got 19 as well. And because I have the higher speed, I guess that means that...
You are, yes, you are correct. You would be, because you have a higher dex bonus, it is because you get it. Okay.
What dex does he have?
Yes, but he's got a...
I've got a 16 dexterity.
You beat me by one.
don't worry. My big people points come in. That dexterity bonus is only going to get higher.
Oh wait!
I'm missing Ray and Young One.
Young One is plus two as well. Right? I think so.
Ray!
I told you, Ray.
Roll initiative.
Young One did worse. Young One did worse.
Ray, you are not the last initiative. Scary, isn't it?
Oh, wait.
He's got a natural one.
Oh, wait, I gotta open... Wait, do I still have Hero Lab? No, I don't. I have to open up my other character sheet because of the bonus I get. Because these are humans. I get a bonus against humans. Oh, that's just for attack, so.
Yep. That's attack.
Yep.
All right.
Wait, I...
No? Oh, there we go.
Wait. Yeah.
I had to take up my other...
All right. No problem. Okay. First initiative is a Dan.
Alright. And we'll look at the situation. Jin, and pull out his crossbow. I don't think any of them are in range, are they?
Crossbow? Crossbow range, yes.
Yeah,
you
can.
Alright, then I'm gonna hit this guy down here, the one I'm moving. You can see him moving.
Which one?
That one. See the one that I'm moving?
Yep. Okay. That's the guy that's been yabbering. So, that's your...
Which one has been yabbering?
The one out in front here that's on the road.
Okay.
The one that I just moved, so that's out.
Yep.
That's D20 plus 5.
Can you guys see the names on those?
No.
Okay. Got it. Okay. That's kind of bad. I need to figure out how to do that. Okay. And I need to find characters so I can find the picture and match up with this.
There you go.
Okay, I got him.
There it is.
All right.
17.
He has an armor class of 15. You have hit him.
All right, I do 1d8 of damage. All right. Straight up roll 1d8 is the question.
I think it's on the top of the second row.
Okay, so...
No,
guys, just not. Letting you know, if you click on a bandit, you can, and you have your mouse cursor over it, it will tell you which one you're at.
Oh, because, so hovering will.
You have to click on hover.
I see. Yeah, okay. Bandit 8. He does have a name.
There you go.
His name's 8.
Yep, I did 3 damage.
All of their parents are really.
Hey, Stray Chaos, how you doing?
Alright. Alright, 3 points of damage?
Yep, all 3 right. points of damage. Oh, yeah, it basically wins.
Alright. 3 points. Where? Ah! It's in front of my face, I'm not paying attention. Three points of damage. All right. Next is then Ixon.
Okay, so I am going to take cover right here. That's complete movement for the turn.
Okay. Next would be Owen Hart.
I can move 6, right?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm gonna eventually flank around here.
Okay.
But I'll end my turn right there.
Alright. Okay. Then the villains. Alright, what do we got? Do I even have any? Oh god. Oh yeah, these guys got heavy clubs. That's her. They're bandits. What else is new? 1, 2, 3. Three, four, six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 6. 6. 6. You notice one thing about these bandits as they're approaching.
What? Other than the fact that they're incredibly stupid?
Well, yeah. Their choice of weaponry is weird.
Clubs?
They all have basically, well, I mean, in essence, they're clubs. They're heavy maces. They're wearing leather armor and carrying. They are not your traditional thief types by any stretch. And no missile weapons.
They're highwaymen.
They are.
Let me get. Their boss is an ogre. Their boss is an ogre. What else would you expect them to use?
They're not. Yeah, the boss isn't an ogre, but it's still. They're.
Not exactly.
They look hardy, but they don't look. I mean, they look hardy and strong, but they don't. They just.
They're half breeds.
They are half breeds actually. So. All right, that was their entire action because they have no way to hit you from range. So, it is now, I do believe it is now Delviner's turn.
Dave, I have a question. Will my characters still get the bonus? Because if they're half-breeds, then...
No, they're considered humans.
Okay.
So you get the bonus. Yes, okay. You get the bonus on these. Okay. All right. Delvin. You know what we need?
What?
Can you add another? Well, we won't worry about it right now, but we'll have to add another character for Ray's Badger.
I know how to do that.
Yeah.
If you could do that really quick, then.
Yeah, but I'm
ready. Nah, don't worry about it right now. Let's see if we can get this combat down. This is going to take the combat's going to take a little bit here because of situations. So. Okay. You have to hit first. There you go. Yeah, you hit. Never mind. Are you going against,
Bandit 8.
Bandit 8.
That same one that, the same one that has a crossbow bolt stuck in.
Yeah, well, he just took a rock to the forehead, too, now.
3 hull points of damage.
Woohoo! Ooh, that's no good.
Yeah.
I just got a text message. Plane crash in Russia.
Damn it, Obama.
Now, aren't we supposed to say damn it, Trump, now?
Darn it. Yeah, let's Hillary become president.
And, it's all Trump's. Warming, Ming, ISIS.
Yeah, we'll talk about it after the game. All right, so let's. That way, I'm horribly distracted, anyways. Okay, young one.
Yeah, I'm just quickly doing something here. Sorry about this.
No, it's a problem. No problem.
I should have programmed this earlier.
For those that are watching, the party consists of a drow, rogue bard, a dwarf who thinks he's an elf, ranger, a dwarf berserker, a female human magus, and a dragon.
Okay.
Out of combat.
So my
and
movement.
Vegas who attempted to dissuade that.
I will tell you what it. You would have had a surprise round on the combat. That's what wouldn't have been for what happened. So we'll talk about that later. Anyways.
So my dragon, young one, could move 60 feet. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll only move five. And then everyone knows what's happening now.
Yep, there's about to be dead people.
Yeah, let's put it this way. Close your ears.
Yep, Adain will fold his ears down and clap.
And so, oh wow, I clicked. I don't want to. I want to remove that. I don't want to put it on there. So, wait, what happened to the? One guy went missing. I must have had it highlighted when I highlighted my dice. Sorry, Dave.
No, that's fine. That's fine. I know which one it was.
Yeah.
So 1, 2, 3.
After the dragon attacks him, anyway.
Yeah, I'm a problem.
4, 5, 6. So pretty much these four will be caught in it.
Okay.
So now to roll it.
All right.
That's the damage.
Right.
Yeah, they're all dead.
I'm gonna make my saving throw. Stop it. Okay.
Dane will scream out after the sound stops. I warned you! I warned you all! You had your chance.
Alright. Wait a minute. I have good saves on this, so that was wrong. Okay.
You would think after the first attack they would be dissuaded, you know?
Yeah, there's possibilities.
I mean, yeah, especially with that one.
Ow.
Yep, somebody's dead.
Ow.
And then a 20.
I believe it's like, I can't remember if it's half or not. I can't remember.
Well, normally.
I know that said.
There you go.
You should be able to drag him on.
Yeah.
That's two. That's hit. Three, that's hit.
That was the four.
Four, so that's...
That's the next round, which means...
Okay, so he takes 14.
It's 17.
He took 17. I'm sorry. My mistake. Three more points. Okay.
Okay, now I'm going to roll to see she has to...
He takes nothing. He takes nothing. Evasion. When you make your reflex save, you take nothing.
Okay, I could do it in two.
Takes nothing.
Two more.
Take 17. And that would be bandit 5. 17. Got it. Okay. Unlike the other system where you couldn't keep track of what number they were. Okay. Sorry, I'm still eating.
So, in two rounds, I'll be able to use Breath Weapon again.
Mm-hmm. And the next turn, Dragon will have a bonus to his attack, as well as pretty much everything in the zone, because somebody's going to be using Bardic Song.
That is why your Bards are the perfect utility characters, because of this.
The Dragon will have a...
And the dragon's gonna have a flank button. Makes it even nastier. Alright.
It's the Dan.
Top of the order, Dan. Go.
Dave, I did whisper to you.
Dan will move down here by dragon. Again. And initiate his bard song. Where he screams out to basically everyone, hit them and kill them fast!
I gotta check something here.
I need to lose their bodies before they grow cold.
I gotta check something here, Dave.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah, oh, it lasted.
No, Ron?
Yes.
For what he is currently doing, it does not require a roll, therefore that does not.
Okay.
Happen. Just so you know.
Okay.
And I want everybody to know, he just said he can't take any cold bodies, which means he can't touch anybody I hit.
Yeah.
No, he'll loot their bodies. He doesn't care.
You just said you can't loot any cold bodies.
No, he said he wanted to loot the bodies before they went cold. He didn't say anything about being adverse.
Well, so the problem is...
cold damage.
You know how Dubs's LX does fire, Ray's does cold.
That doesn't matter, did it? That's Bard Song on Dragon, on Badger, on Ray, and probably on Ixen, too.
The only person that's not currently affected is our, unfortunately, behind-the-scenes person.
Yeah, the...
If you... first off the bat, okay, so Dan does that. You can attack or do something else as well as the Bard Song, just so you know. You can, shoot right, or if you want.
If you don't want to attack, you can aid the dragon to hit.
No, Adan is actually going to attack this guy that I'm moving here.
Yep, got it.
Because he's not going to attack into a dragon.
Instead of moving him, Toban, click on drawing tools and you could actually circle him with the pen tool.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, okay.
Alright, I'm going to attack. Let's use my attack with crossbow. Nope, it misses. It completely flies.
It plings off of the rock. You had it too low.
It just plings off the rock.
Yep. Alright.
Where are you aiming at?
He wasn't.
No. You don't understand.
I've been making sure you guys hit them.
You don't understand it because she's yelling at you in Draconic.
Here we go again. All right. Action, go.
Okay. Okay. Wait, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
Shoot. Next. I can move up to him, but I can't attack.
I'm gonna. Dubs, there's a couple things we need to do with you will be up there quickly in a moment. So.
Actually, I'm going to climb. 1, 2, 3, 4, and I can attack. I jump. Right. I go over the rock.
Okay.
And.
Which means plus one to your hit, Ron.
Yep, you are a plus one to hit because of the bard song.
And I have.
Remember, you tried to spell cast on that same bard.
You don't know what happened. You don't know what happened. And I get. So I get a plus 9 to attack.
Yes, you do.
Yep. All thanks to the drow rogue.
Yep.
Not nice completely. And am I sort of flanking him or no?
No.
Okay.
No, you're not. Flanking works weird in Pathfinder.
Okay, so
you literally, to get a flank, have to have the person exact opposite of where you're standing.
Actually, Dave, I get a plus 10 because I'm currently at a plus 8. Because my base attack bonus went up when I leveled up.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yep. You're right.
I'm at a plus 10, so we just add 2 to whatever I roll. So 25.
You hit him.
Okay. Well. And so does that plus one?
Plus one more to damage. Yes, you get plus one more.
No, I'm talking about a Dan's thing, or is that just a hit?
Yeah, so I'm talking about.
Okay, so I get it.
You're rolling only to Dave. We're not seeing your rolls.
Oh shoot! Sorry.
Yeah.
He hit.
I'm seeing it.
Yeah, I accidentally left it in the DM's whisper. So I'm going to be attacked, obviously, with two hands. So
yep.
Plus 2 to that, which gives it a plus 11. It'll give it 11 total damage.
11 total damage. Pow. It.
Wow.
Ron can fight. There's.
Yeah. Where okay. Ron, most of these guys are fighters. The Dan's are more of a support character.
Okay. All right. Dubs.
All right. Can I go through
okay,
the screen
thing? Here's the rule. Okay. That we're skipping here and that. Will now come into effect since you're back there. You can move twice your move and not attack.
Okay, yeah, because you're doing a full-out run.
You're doing a full-out run.
Can I go through the screen thing?
Yes, you can. That's a tree. You dodge the, you know.
You could run through the forest.
Cut through the trees and set the tiny bits of forest on fire.
Yeah, that's right. It's not like, you know, you don't have a very big object that can cut shit.
Yeah, I think Dave temporarily forgot that you have that giant flaming battle. too.
Alright, I'll end my turn. And I'm near Bandit 1.
Okay.
And
got
he's
it.
In Bardsong range, too.
Yep. Now he gets in Bardsong range. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Now, the other thing, Dubs, one other thing that you need to know, especially about your character,
mm-hmm.
you got to remember the berserking can be
activated.
Well, you got a number of rounds, you can berserk for a number of rounds equal to your level. So, you haven't done it yet, but, you know, if you want to start going big time damage, if you need to at some point, that's what you do. And if you looked at your powers, all of your powers are actually get more powerful when you're berserk, when you're drunk.
Okay, isn't that liquid courage or something?
Yeah.
Or where is it?
Yeah, it's liquid courage. I think that's what it's called.
Liquid something, I know it's called.
Yeah. All right, I'll pop you up in here. So, hold on, I got you. All right. Oh, wait, you get more than that in a round. You also have another +4 on that. So, okay, you're barbarian. Liquid courage. Each alcoholic drink consumed grants +1 to all mind-affecting saving throws.
Well, didn't I have, like, a whole bar before this fight?
Yeah.
A whole bar.
Yeah. You pretty much did.
Well, here's the other ability is when he's in mode, he can attack. Every time he drinks drinks alcohol during the battle, he gets a new saving throw.
He's basically drunken master style.
He's drunken barbarian style. Every time he takes a drink of alcohol, he can get another saving throw. That is scary. Okay.
Until he passes out.
Yeah, well, his constitution's, I think, the highest in the party, so that's going to be a while, too. All right.
Yeah, my constitution's not going to ever be that.
Yeah, you're not drinking anybody under a table at this point.
He's beating the dragon in con?
The dragon, the dragon's ridiculous.
No, the dragon's 17.
No, they just gambles everybody under.
Yeah, well, no, you gamble them until they're stripped naked. Now, let's get this right.
Dave, GM whisper.
Yeah. Not powerful enough yet, actually.
Okay.
Yes, but not yet.
Okay.
Yeah. It's very good question. Not quite yet. You're not quite there. Okay. My Schmeg Monkeys. Okay, so Schmeg Monkeys. And they are, what is their attack? Can they actually hit something? Yes, they can.
Donald Trump won in UFC. He's a champion.
God. Okay, first one against you, Ron. I forgot the summary.
Miss, because my AC is 17 right now against them.
Yep. Against young one.
Guess who just entered chat?
Young one is AC 16, so a hit.
Okay.
Wow! Wait, no, I was looking at the wrong character sheet.
I think the dragon
AC 20. AC 20.
The dragon has the best armor class in the party. That's why I wasn't moving.
AC 20.
The dragon is kind of a tank. Okay, so that is number two. Let's see. One, two. Is that all of my, I got two idiots win, don't I? Okay, I can't see Discord at the moment, guys, so give me a sec here. Hey, Tumi, don't worry about it, man. We need to get you set up for World 20, for Epic Table. We'll get that for you in We'll have it set up for the Marvel game. Not Marvel. Jeez. Champions game. So, we'll get you set up. Just, not a problem, though. Dude, we started late, and we've been fighting, trying to learn the system in here and everything else, so. All right.
Rebel Alliance, they just used Archer.
Yep, okay,
Jedi,
so I got... Nice. The great Jedi door opener. What's your badgers?
I didn't roll as
one. No. What is your badger's armor class?
Plus. Sixteen.
I missed the first attack, but I hit the second attack. And I forgot the summary again. 5 points of damage to the badger. And I have one attack more on Ron. And I miss.
Oh, so three. I have two attacking me now.
Yes, you have two attacking you. Yeah, but you got a buddy coming right next to you though. So,
No, that's okay. That's obviously. What?
All right. The next is Delvin and the Badger. Now, everything's good. When we leave, everything's still set here, correct?
That is correct.
Okay. Good man.
I don't know.
Plus two to hit with the flank, because of the flank, so. Unless you're a rogue. Then you get four.
A hit, regardless.
Yeah. Wow. Ray, roll again. But the flank, that confirms. So roll your damage twice. Unless you're using a times three weapon. I think you're times two weapon.
Jay.
It is a crit three.
It is a crit three. Roll your damage three times.
Dave, I got a quick question. The character, let's see here. This character, how far away do you think it would be from me?
Oh, yeah, that is 10, 20, it's 20 feet.
Okay.
Yep, 20 feet. Well, 25, actually. It's 25 as I count it.
Okay. Okay, then that's not going to work. I wanted to get all...
20 points of damage to this little guy right here. Ow.
Badger turn. Badger.
Now it's the badger's turn on him.
Yeah.
Each bandit would sound like Christopher Walken. Ooh! Ow! You had me in my tushy.
Hey.
Light misses.
Dave, all I can say is Black Canary.
The badger is not even being helped by the flank. Okay. Meanwhile, Ray hits a times three crit on the Navy. What is wrong with this picture? Ray rolling a crit.
Wait, isn't he supposed to be rolling crit fails?
Yeah, like I said. You may have found the system, Ray, that actually works in your favor. Alright. Sorry, I gotta keep teasing him about that stuff.
I did roll low 3 times
in a row. Roll for the badger, yes. Okay, fair enough. Alright. It is dragon time.
Okay.
Stop. Dragon time.
So, Dave, I got a question. If I move down, if by chance the one that's diagonal from me dies, would I be able to go to the next one?
No, once you hit, once you fight, you can't.
Okay.
You're not going to be able to move.
No, if I moved and then attack, but I understand what you're saying.
Okay, hold on a second, Ren. Okay, what, Ray?
Does the cold damage persist?
No, it just adds to the, it adds an extra d6 to the damage. It's not the one that persists.
I just rolled straight, so I don't know.
Okay. Did you add the d6 on each one of them?
No. That's
not okay, one. Roll 3d6.
Yeah, that's what I was asking.
It's a D6 for each hit. It's just like Dubs' weapon. It's exactly the same. It's the cold version of it.
I didn't have that on there. I had to ask.
Yep. Okay. If they are vulnerable to cold, they will take the damage. By the way, undead or not, are immune to cold. Just so you guys know. For future reference. Ray's weapon against undead is not as effective as Dubs.
Dubs' weapon can pretty much set anything on fire, though.
Yes.
It's always that. The fire is more effective than cold.
Yep. Well, it's really bad because, like I said, undead are immune to cold. That's the one advantage that undead had. One of the big advantages of undead.
And 13 cold.
Where is it? Yep. Ray.
We have one frosty dead bandit.
We have one bandit on ice. Okay. Dead man. Ray killed the guy in one hit. And you got and Marana thought he could do damage. Alright, anyways. What's sad is if Dubs criticals.
Oh,
he's got the weapon from heck for criticals.
I've got the heavy pick then. So.
Yeah, well, true. Okay. Anyways. We are to... Okay, so now, Ron, back to the dragon real quick. You want to move the dragon.
Right there. Yeah.
Right there.
Okay, yeah.
You can do that. If you moved more than one square, I'd get a free shot at you.
No, I was going to.
If you only moved one square, you don't get. I don't get the free shot.
So I would only be able to attack the one right beside me.
All right, now you have Mr. Dragon.
Because I was thinking of doing one attack, and then I have two other attacks afterwards.
Dragon has the ability to multi-attack. You can attack. You would have to tell me how you're splitting the attacks to which guy, but you can do all of your little moves.
Okay. I'm
splitting them up between the two characters.
The one beside me, I'm going to do the bite attack too.
Mm-hmm.
And then the claw and wing attack, I'm doing the one below me.
Got it.
That's what I wanted to do. Because I'm.
The dragon has that ability to.
Because I'm figuring the one beside me doesn't have very many hit points left.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to bite.
Don't forget your plus ones.
So
one of those attacks.
So that's a plus 1d20 plus 11.
Yep.
It gets crazy when you get somebody that can buff all of your attacks.
Uh-huh. This is why bards are good.
Oh, I've played bards.
And I miss.
A rogue bard.
Ah, yes, you do. You do miss the bite. Okay, but do the rest of the attacks against the other.
Okay, and the same thing for the others. It's the same.
Yep.
That is impossible!
Ray, you have transferred your dice luck to Ron.
That's two ones, Ron. You want to try again?
That's a hit.
Okay, so 1d... Oh, sorry, no, the wings are plus 5, so I get a plus 6.
Okay. Yep. That's still a hit. The random dice random number generator is happening.
Hello? All right. What did you say? Sorry, you got cut off.
Oh, the random number generator is having fun with us now.
Watch the dragon miss its first two shots. Look over to Exon, look over to dragon.
The one below me gets 6 damage.
Kay. He knows he's safer that way.
Alright, let's see what the...
God. Oh, wait, is that... when it says times two, do I roll twice?
Or no, it's two attacks.
Okay, it's wing... two attacks with the wings, so it's just one roll.
No, it's two rolls.
Oh! So I actually...
The dragon should have 5 attacks.
So I should get to roll another...
attack.
Oh, so...
And another claw, right?
Yeah. So, let's... miss one claw and hit the other claw.
Right.
Okay, so I'm going to finish off the wing first. So, okay, 6 damage for one.
Okay, 6 damage. Oh, I forgot who this was. Who is this dude? This dude is called Bandit 5. Okay.
Okay, I have to roll. Okay. I have to roll another wing attack.
Yes, roll another wing attack.
Miss.
Myths.
Now I have to do claw damage to the one below me, which is 1d6 plus 3.
Yep.
Oh, 1d6 plus 4.
Yep, 4. Yep, you're okay. 4.
And 9. So a total of 15 damage altogether with my 6 previously.
And the breath weapon that killed him.
And guess what? Next round, I could do the breath weapon again.
Yep. Dan.
Yes, sir.
You are up, sir.
All right, Dan's moving here.
Perfect.
Oh and no. Okay, keep going.
Is the guy? I'm wondering if the guy is facing completely towards Vixen.
Yes. You get your backstab.
Yep, so that's plus 1 for the backstab, plus 1 plus for the pincer.
No. Plus 1, what are you hitting at? No. You get... No. You're a thief, on a flank, you get plus 4.
Just plus 4 to my regular attack, okay.
You're plus 4 on your regular attack, you do double damage.
Alright, so...
If you hit.
So it's d20 plus 7.
Right. So you're 5th, right? You need 3 times damage, I think. No, don't. You only get 2 times damage at the moment. Okay, go ahead and roll.
Alright, add the regular plus 4 to this.
Yes.
Yeah, the RNG is really...
Yeah, it's kind of crazy right now, okay.
I like it. It does bring that unpredictability.
Yes, it does. Okay, but it was a nice try at it, and you would have done quite a bit of damage with that, even with your slight penalty that you do have. All right,
yeah,
Ixon.
That pretty much would have killed
him.
Ixon.
My
if you attack the one directly, if you attack the one directly below you,
yeah,
you have a plus 2 extra to hit.
Well, my character sees Ixon running behind the one that's in front of her, as smiles as she lets out a sonic scream.
Okay.
Alright. I'm putting this in chat, in the... to everyone. This is what it is.
Alright.
Cause, yeah, Ixion, yeah. So...
Yeah, ow, it's this one, okay. Alright. I gotta look up one thing. Before you do any rolling, let me look up something real quick. Yep. Okay. Alright, checking. Alright. Okay, so it is a go ahead and roll your D4 damage.
D4.
Yep.
Do I get a plus one to humanoids? No, it's magic, never mind.
This is magic, this isn't your attack, so... Yeah,
no. Roll 4d4.
Yep.
8.
Alright. Now, I want you to roll a d20 plus your intelligence bonus. I didn't explain this before. Plus, like I said, plus your D20 plus your intelligence bonus. Plus, this is a what level spell?
This is a level 2.
Plus 2.
So a plus 5 altogether.
Yes. D20 plus 5. Okay. Alright, so now I roll a saving throw.
Yes,
I got it. Don't worry.
I wonder if it's...
Yes, yeah, you...
Dan does, too. Dan needs to roll a save as well. It's a cone effect.
DC 5. DC 15.
One of these days, I'm going to remember the summary ability on this. I will. Oh, it's true. It's true.
Would my saving throw be will?
Reflex.
Reflex.
So that's plus 3. D20 plus 3.
Nope.
My straight initiative roll.
Okay, you... Oh, no, that's safe.
More than that. Wait, whoa. Reflex. Your reflex should not be that... That roll should not be that low for you, sir. Where is the saving throws?
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Your reflex saves 9, dude.
Yeah.
And you get a plus 1 because you're doing Bard Song.
Yep. Yep.
So you're plus 10.
But even if you make it, you get half damage.
Rogue ability.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm a rogue. Yes. They tend to be able to get out of situations like that.
Okay, let me explain. Anytime a rogue makes a reflex save that the attack normally does half damage, it does
not. Oh, yeah, I keep forgetting.
Yeah, I'm a rogue.
This is why being a rogue is also a good thing. Okay. Anyways, let me find out who.
Bard? Yeah, it's pretty hard to kill.
Is it kind of bad that I'm hoping he rolls a 1?
Such love. Such love. Go ahead and roll, Mr. Kelvin. The problem is,
Bron will have to kill my other character even worse.
Yeah, I know.
All that character will do is annoying her. Endlessly.
Yeah. Alright, roll.
Tobin, roll!
Roll, please, roll.
So it's D20 plus 10.
Yes, it's D20 plus 10.
Alright, I'm rolling my initiative, just add plus 7.
Okay, fine, that works.
No. And then it just dodges out of the way of the sound.
Woo! Well, which bandit got the 9?
The bandit, it's bandit 1 that failed. so he's the one that took damage.
Okay, so he was already damaged, so is he kaput yet?
So he's in good shape. All right, he's in good shape.
Yeah, can a Dan move out of flanking because of that dodge state?
No, you can't, no. In champions, yes. In this game, no. If you abort to a dodge in champions, you can move a square. You can move a meter in any direction. But okay, now this now comes down to Mr. Tobin.
I'm just asking something because Bandit One took damage from me previously.
Right, he's really hurt.
Oh, okay, you said he's fine. You said he's fine, so that's what I was wondering.
No. I'm saying is that the situation is fine because because our erstwhile berserker is up next.
Yes.
Dubs, you there?
I'm here with that.
Alright.
Your turn.
Yeah, and you got two very fresh targets.
Not very fresh.
One very annoyed-looking drow.
So that means I have three level 2 spells.
And do some kind of crazy dance.
Yeah, but I know what I gave to... Hush! I know what I gave Tobin. I'm not Tobin, but I know what I gave Dubs. Come on. This could get ugly. Let's see what happens here.
Alright. For right now, can I take a swig of alcohol?
Yep.
And activate liquid courage?
Yep.
Now, when I swing with my flaming axe, is there any more pluses that I have to do?
When you get your liquid courage, you use your rage power and take the drink. You now have another +2 to hit and damage.
Okay, so I could add that to the axe?
Yes.
All right. So I'm gonna hit Bandit One.
All right.
21.
Whoops! No, that was okay. No, that was your
damage.
Did you roll damage?
Oh, my bad. I forgot. Got mixed up.
That's all right.
How do I start it off again with a
one d20 plus your attack plus now another 2.
Yeah.
And then plus 1 for the bard song. So you're actually up plus 3 at the moment.
So we have my great axe, right?
It's
a d20 plus 9, right?
Right.
But I add those 2 on there or 2 on the damage?
No, on the 2 hit. It's plus 3 to hit extra or on top of that. So you had plus 9, so you should be plus 12. Should be 20 plus 12.
13.
Yeah. Here's that dice rolling.
And now the damage? Or did I?
Because you missed actually with that roll.
Oh. Well.
Okay.
That's what happens when you're drunk.
Yeah. But you're 6th level, correct?
Correct.
Okay. You get another attack, but for a second attack, you should have at this point in time. Because I know I built your character, so I know this. All right. Roll a d20 plus 7. The 26. Two people, okay, that hit. Now you can roll your damage. Ray, if it wasn't for that level of cleric, you'd be doing this.
I know.
Yeah.
19.
Okay. And you better match. That'd be 36 points, and he don't have that much. Okay.
Dan watches as one of them goes down flaming.
Flaming. Goes down flaming. You gotta get that extra piece.
In half.
Probably everything on his body is burnt to a crisp now.
Now, here's the other part. Dubs, on your character sheet, look under feats.
He has a cleave.
I think I gave him cleave.
Oh boy. My favorite.
Yep, I have a cleave.
Okay, so now you get
that another attack.
D20, that D20 plus 7.
Okay.
You're gonna do that against the guy next, the other guy. Okay, you missed, but that's what cleave allows you to do.
Okay.
If a character dies on your attack, you can turn as long as they're adjacent and attack them. The next character. Eventually, you'll get great cleave, or that will continue, and you become the giant Cuisinart.
Basically, you stick one and you stick one in the stomach, and then slice all around you.
Yeah.
All right, I'm not drunk enough yet to get a combo, I guess.
Exactly. But this is why I was laughing with Tony, because yeah, he could do single target really nasty damage. Dubs can keep going and going and going and going.
Just wait until my dragon gets cleave.
Yes, the dragon gets cleave. The dragon gets cleave, which is when you think about how many attacks it has and each one gets a cleave.
So if I kill one, I get another 5 attacks. I kill that one, I get another 5 attack.
No. It's whichever attack succeeded in killing the critter, you get the cleave off of.
Okay.
That's how the work how it works.
It's different.
It's on one. It's just it's whichever one hits, you move to the next one. So okay, we are at the bandits now. We're about gonna have to suspend here, I think.
I just mentioned to the people that I'll be late due to a previous engagement.
I am surrounded by 3 people, but I am still trying to attack. So, Banda de Taco! Ooh, I hit you, Ron.
Hit me.
For a mighty 2 points of damage!
The thing is, apparently from what I read, my sonic cone is still in effect. So next round.
Yeah, you've got two more rounds of that it has 2 more rounds of effect. Yes. This is that sonic cone is nasty. It just doesn't do really a lot of damage, but the continual effect is quite
it nasty. It's a DOT. It's a dot.
It's exactly what it is. Okay. We have Bandit 8 is going to attempt to attack the dragon. Good luck on that. Missed. This guy moves up. This guy has no desire to take on the dragon. This guy moves up here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Does he walk into
the attack? No, he wasn't in the initial. So.
Oh, I thought. Oh, okay.
Oh, unless wait a minute. Let me read that real quick. Let me come back up here.
Because it's a continued thing. I don't think I could attack next round. It's just a continued.
Oh, yo, until you use. No, if you read the bottom of it, Ron, you can still attack physically, but you cannot use your magic power in verbal spells or anything. For the next 2 rounds.
So it's like a web thing. Almost like a web. It's a continuous thing.
It's a canary cry.
Yeah.
It's the canary cry from DC, Black Canary.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright, so I got 2 attacks on Ray.
Looks like we got more friends and prizes.
What is, Ray, what's your armor class again? I know I hit you once.
My current armor class. I have 16.
Okay. I think that's right. Did you get pick up any magic armor?
I think I increased it because it's now 16.
Okay, it was 15. That's right. Okay, well I hit you both times. So, You take 11 points of damage total.
Dave, I will have a question, and this is a very important question. Mm-hmm. You know why I'm drawing this? Would this be allowed? Would it hit like that?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Good.
Yes, you can do it.
Okay,
exactly
good.
Exactly what I expected you to do. They didn't expect that. That's exactly the way it works. So, I'll have to look it up, but I'll let you do it this time at least.
Because I want to try avoid Ray.
Yeah, no, that would avoid Ray. That's the question. Yeah, I'll worry about it later. Okay, Dubs, I hit you, I think. Yes, I did hit you. Dubs, I did 7 points of damage to you.
No.
Hassan smash. Bandito Frito attack.
You guys, did you just notice that?
Yes. Okay. Wow.
I had to do something silly. All right. It is then, I am done with my attacks. Therefore, it is Ray.
I will. Okay. First, my roll.
Yeah, unless you do the tumble trick.
He doesn't have tumbling.
Exactly. Yeah, it ain't gonna happen. So, alright. Thieves get away with that a whole lot better.
What are our current extra bonuses?
Plus, you're at plus one from the bard song. Okay. Alright, you hit.
Attack.
That's a hit.
Right. Hammer. Plus 6 damage and plus 6 from the cold.
Plus a d6.
Oh, 2d6. Just roll 2d6.
Yeah, just roll 2d6 and then your 2 damage rolls. Or for whichever weapon.
Drake Knapp says, hi, Dave.
Hey, Drake. I haven't talked to you. I've tried to catch you. How are you doing? I've been trying to catch you in Rushlock's Discord. How you been? Like I said, I haven't talked to you very much. Of course, my time on the game has been sucky, but...
3 damage cold.
Is that the badger or you?
That was me.
Okay, but what about the rest of your damage?
That's what I'm rolling.
Okay.
But I got the wrong dice roll. It should be. That would be the. Just the hammer.
Okay.
The light hammer should. Yeah.
Right. Only the one that's got the cold damage gets the cold damage. Yeah. Right.
That's a d8.
Ah, okay.
Let's call it that.
Nah, hey.
Oh, I see. What
I'm did. Sorry. I didn't see all you need is. Yeah, Twitch didn't change the stupid thing like it was supposed to.
There's the Warhammer damage, and that doesn't help. So it'd be 9.
Okay. It's 9 to which one?
One, and 7.
Okay, 9 to 7. Okay, got it. I'm a little distracted playing Game Master. You can understand. But, yeah, I sent the change thing and it didn't change. You gotta love Twitch sometimes. I'll tell you right now, it probably tweeted out mutants and masterminds the way the Twitch works. Okay, so 9 points of damage. You hit your second attack, your other attack. Okay. Normally I stream Marvel, and Drake got me into his guild for Marvel.
The question I have to ask, I won't do it this time, but can I use the heavy pick and the Warhammer sizes?
Yes, you can use them both. You can, but they're at a -2. Actually, at a -2 to hit. Well, wait a minute. You're Ranger. No, they're not. Never mind.
And he is a dwarf too. So I was going to say, is it a Warhammer usually two-handed?
It can be, but I use two fighting.
Yeah, that's.
It's part of it. That's part of his Ranger ability.
Oh, this is Marvel Heroes, by the way. You didn't get the new update, guys? No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, this is an amazing multiplayer spinoff of Marvel Heroes.
It's the Wednesday game.
No, Ray is playing Thor, wielding two Mjolnirs. Tobin is Loki.
Pretty close.
I can't remember what's her name from Sylphie or.
Oh.
Alright, there's the Warhammer, literally pick damage.
Alright.
Nothing. And now for the Badger attacks.
Okay. Yeah, the Loki reference, that was good, Ron.
Come on.
Badger, you can roll better than that.
And the fun thing about it, you know, that
we can't.
Doesn't Thor have a badger in, I honestly thought he did, but no, I might be wrong.
With
anyways.
The Bart song, the last roll would be a 14. Aw.
You need a 15.
Okay, the badger's just sitting there going.
Alright.
Frothing at the mouth.
Because that's what. Okay, it's time for the throne. Yep.
Yes. Yes, Thor has a badger.
There you go. Raise Thor. It's a little short for a Thor, but he's his old Thor. Yeah.
Okay, dragon time?
Yep.
Okay.
What would dubs be then? I guess dubs would be tier then, possibly, because of the battle axe. I don't know.
No, maybe the Norse god of drink and merriment?
No, he's Jim.
Yeah,
Odin.
Yeah, we'll have to lose an eye for that one. Okay.
Actually, what is Thor's big fat guy? Volstagg?
Volstagg.
That's Volstagg. Who I meant. Yeah. That's who I meant.
Yeah, Volstagg. Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah, Volstagg always gets drunk. There you go.
So this is my second round, so I could use my breath weapon again.
Yes.
Breath weapon damage. 18. Hit all three.
Wow. You know what's worse? It's that the same thing. I rolled the same saving throw.
That's what happened with me. Oh, wow.
Random number generator. I don't know, man. I'm starting to laugh about it. Get rid of him. He's done.
And the other two...
You did how much? 18?
Yep.
Oh, man. Did you do that? Yep.
All three dead?
Nope. 1 point wonder. That was first time he got damaged, so he's okay. I mean, comparably.
Comparably.
Yeah. Okay, top of the order.
Oh, wait, I have to roll one more.
Well, no, he goes first.
I have to roll when... Okay, three rounds.
Oh, that, yeah.
Yeah, all right. There are these two guys here.
Mm-hmm.
And Dane will move out of the way, holding his ears still.
Next round, you'll still have to check.
No, he actually won't.
No.
It doesn't say you have three saving throws, though. That's what.
I think it's only one saving throw.
It's one saving.
Okay.
Throws. Yeah, it's not three saving throws. It's one saving. Now, if it was three, then you save again, but then you'd also have the spell resistance again too. So.
Yeah, you've got the saving throw, then you've got the spell resistance.
It's spell resistance first, then save. So.
Alright, I'm attacking with the sword.
Yep.
And that's the plus one for Bard Song, and the plus one for the pincer attack.
No, it's not plus one for you, it's plus four. I keep telling you that.
Plus four.
You are a rogue, you get plus four on the pincer attacks.
So I hit.
You hit.
So it's 1d8.
And this is literally multiplied by 2, but go ahead and roll it. Instead of rolling twice, it's the actual multiplier for backstab.
Put that in there.
Yeah, you can't do multiply in that, unfortunately. If it did, then we'd have our champion's problems.
Yeah. I'm just putting this in his damage.
Yep. Okay, you're putting it in as a save on the thing. Yeah, okay. I get you.
I actually like this as for the battle. I mean...
Times that by 2. That's 8.
Yep.
This program for battling is so much neater than Roll 20.
I'll be very honest with you. The fact I could click on this, look at him, say know which character it is, you know, before I had to try to put labels, and then you guys couldn't see him, and then I couldn't see him, and then I had to... I like this.
No, he does 8 damage.
Okay, gotcha. Alright. Okay, now you roll 2d4, Ron.
2d4.
Yep.
Five.
Alright. Okay, got that. And now you do whatever you need to do for an attack.
Okay, so... I know the one diagonal for me is almost dead. I'll be kind and let them finish off it off. So I'll grab the one in front of me.
Alright.
Black Blade hit. I get a plus 2 above this because one for a song and one for the human thing.
Right.
So I get a 20. Not a natural 20, but a 20.
No. Okay, you hit. Roll damage.
So again, I get another plus 2 to it.
Yes. Yes.
15.
That was a good shot. My throat's getting a little sore, so okay. Turned out it was gold, guys, by the way. I thought I had strep, but because of the guy that was next to me at work, it turned out to be a cold, so we're okay. It's still better than the influenza. that the one employee has.
Oh, I was off a week of... I was off of... Sorry, go ahead.
Go ahead.
I was off of 3 days of work because of influenza.
Yeah, this is the full-blown influenza.
The type B?
The you sit your butt at home and you out for a week.
Yeah, no, that's what I had to.
Yeah, the problem is he's a trainee. He doesn't have time.
Oh, ouch.
She's one of the other T trainees.
Ouch.
So yeah, they're being really nice with him, but he's gonna have a lot of sick issues, and he's losing money is what he's doing right now, which is not good.
Oh, I did a role as a young one. That should have been me.
That's okay. All right. Next is our erstwhile berserker dwarf.
Yep, with the two guys that are wicked in front of him. And he gets pincer, too.
Wait, he's moving? What?
Bandit 2.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
And right. Activate Liquid Courage, because I took another swig.
Mm-hmm. Actually, you're going to want to be here, just so you know.
Okay.
If you move another, I get a free shot at you if you do. Because so of you're moving through his what the
hip box.
If you move from here to here, you're shot at you. I just want to let you know that's the way the rules work on that.
That brings up my hit to 9, right?
Yep.
And let's hope for good luck.
Mm-hmm.
Damn. Okay.
Roll again.
18.
not a confirmed.
He confirmed the critical.
Okay, so...
Yeah, now you roll your damage 3 times. Because you have a bad life.
Somebody's gonna die.
Yeah, this guy is... Okay, 13...
Okay, and final.
Jesus. Squirk.
Yeah.
And hold on. You now get your full attack on this guy here. You get a full attack on Bandit 9. So roll a 2-hit. So roll a 2-hit. You could do this many times. This is why your character can get disgusting.
With the plus 9 or down to plus 7?
Nope, you're full pluses.
27. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, he doesn't crit that time, though. But this is, but yeah. Okay, roll your damage.
20.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Bandit 9.
Now, this was where the Great Cleave would come in. You don't have the Great Cleave, but you're not close enough yet. You're not close enough to the enemy, but yeah. Yeah, you just wiped out 2 guys, dude.
Alright.
Hey, and you know what? I'm multitasking so much that I'm beating people up in this game and UFC, so...
Alright.
I'm a fighter in me.
Yep, that's it, man. I made your character disgusting for a reason. I thought you'd like this character because of this. Alright. It is the bandit's turn. However, there's a problem for the bandits.
Are they shaking in fear?
Yeah, that's what I'm going to be rolling.
They kind of lost most of their numbers.
Well, no, I think after the loss of their leader, they would...
The loss of the leader, they have to make a will save.
The loss of their leader and many.
And remember how I'm saying this, they have to make a will save. These are rogues. Will saves tend to be the worst roll they have.
Yeah.
Except for a Dan.
Well, no, you've got... And I forgot the summary again, didn't I?
Yes, 11.
11.
5.
5. Got 2 more.
19. 10.
One of them's not weak.
Please let it be the one hit point one that decided not to leave. That would be freaking hilarious. Oh my word, it is the one hit point one that decided it could take us.
Yes, the one that has one hit point left is the one that's remaining.
Come on, guys, we can take him! Guys! Oh,
guys! Ray, I missed you! Destroy him!
Is there a leader?
Dead.
Oh, okay.
The dragon breath weaponed him twice.
Woohoo! A badger.
Missed twice.
Yeah! The badger's gonna take up dancing, because that's all he's doing behind these things.
Yeah, so far. left.
Alright. Ray.
I've missed 5 times in a row.
Wow.
Okay, my turn. Or dragons.
Yes, it's your turn because Ray can't kill the one hit.
Okay, this is only 5. This is only 25. This is only 25, so I'll do my.
So your dragon is chasing down everyone but the one hit point one.
Well, the one hit point wonder can't move. The one hit point wonder, if he runs at this point in time, the badger gets a free shot at him.
Yep. Okay, I get a plus. Bite. So I get a plus 11 to a d20 roll. Because of the roll d20. Oops. Hey, you changed my dice on me. One d20 plus 11. Hit.
Yep.
So 1d8. Plus 5. Mm-hmm. 10.
Still standing.
Okay, now comes one claw attack. 1d20 plus 11. Hit.
Yep.
Hit.
Ew, I was close on that the other one. Okay.
1d6 plus, so that's 2d6. No, actually, it's just 1d6 plus 3. I'll roll twice because they'll get too convoluted. No, plus 4.
Yep.
1, 2. And then 1d6 plus. Is he dead?
He's dead.
Okay.
He's dead. Okay.
I wanted.
So if the dragon really wants to start tearing him apart.
You know what? Chaotic good. Bandits are evil.
Yep.
We're Cobra Kai. We show no mercy. Sweep the leg, Johnny.
1d6 plus 5 plus 5. And then damage 1d4 plus. There we go.
There we are. The dragon put him at negative 22.
And we'll call him that. I like that dragon.
Chaotic good. And.
Well, they did say they wanted its skills, so really blame it.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I don't. Yeah.
Yeah, I can get to the one hit point wonder next turn.
Yep, it's your turn too, by the way.
All right.
Get over there.
Blink.
I want to see a Dan kill one of the bandits. I just want to see it.
I'm going to attack.
Because it's
going to
be rare.
18? That should hit.
Yeah, that is a hit.
That's a hit. That's definitely a hit.
Damage, 4 points.
That's all you need, man. All you need when you got one.
Dan will walk up to the final bandit and basically stab him in the gut.
Yep.
No, thump him over the head with the hilt of your dagger.
He doesn't use daggers.
Yeah, he actually doesn't have a dagger. He's got a sword. He has no dagger.
He actually uses.
He gave away the daggers to Ray, actually.
Yeah, this is an unusual rogue.
Oh, ho, ho.
Hey, Ixen. Ixen.
Yes, one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Threaten to skin my dragon, will you? Okay, so black blade hit 20.
Roll again.
Oh, that would actually be a 30. So I'll.
But it don't matter.
Yeah.
But roll a d20 again. You confirmed. You roll your damage twice.
Okay, let me.
Written very well in this game. I'm noticing it's like ones and twenties. It's kind of weird.
Okay, so I get
the random generator is kind of.
Except when it comes to me and rolling my usual checks, then it does.
Damage. 1d8 plus 4. Two hands. 1d8 plus 5.
Yep. Plus one from the bird song.
And plus, so 1d8 plus 7.
Right.
14. 12.
That second one got him. He was wounded.
That's the last bandit. Oh.
Nope. There is one more bandit.
There is one bandit. He's way over here. Bandit 3. It's the bandit. However, it is Tobin's turn. Tobin's turn. Shit. It is Dubs' turn.
What was the last bandit?
Was that your bar? Was that your dwarf that burped like that?
Yeah, that was me.
Oh, okay. As we hear a loud belch coming from the right.
Yeah. Yeah, the last bandit's the one way out there. Dubs.
Okay.
Unless you have a ranged weapon, you're probably not going to be able to catch him.
Last one.
Well, you can run to him. Yep.
Or
you can run to him, but you wouldn't be able to attack.
Wait, so I was over here.
Yeah, he ran last turn for his turn.
3, 4, 5. Can I go diagonal? Or?
Yeah.
You're going to go one diagonal for every two straight. Is the way the rules work. Because diagonals are actually a little bit longer.
So distance just stay wise. Right there.
Okay. And there is a character that can catch him, so, well, kind of.
That's not me.
No. Well, the bandit moves. You can take away your circle now for.
Okay.
That wasn't me.
Hmm?
I didn't put that
circle. No, I did.
No, Ron did. Okay. He goes to there. He's still keeping defensive, so he's not full out running at this point. So. Okay, so that was his move. This means it's Ray's move. If Ray wants to move. Ray has a ranged attack, so Ray might want to move. Problem is Ray's also got a short ranged weapon, not long ranged weapon that I know of, at least. Wow. Passenger airplane, all lives lost. Crashed
yeah,
in Russia.
I'm watching that on CNN right
now.
Yeah. You guys don't hear it, which means you probably won't hear my friend air conditioner. Summer.
Okay. Yeah.
With my mic's new position, I was worried.
Yeah, an airline in Russia, an airliner trying to land in Russia crashed and killed everybody on board.
Like, it looks like it was one of the older models, so it doesn't, you know, surprise me.
Yeah. Well, it could also be a Russian made. The Russian made one actually look like our older ones because they stole the plans, but, you know.
Yeah, the Russian made. Yeah, they're made.
Ray, I don't think you can hit from there if you're going to use the daggers. So unless you have something longer.
Daggers and the
stinger. Yeah, you're too. I think it's going to be too far for you.
Daggers are 10 feet.
We'll cry out. Just let him run. He's not a threat.
Yeah. Well, there's only one person that can catch him, and it's that person's turn, or dragon's turn.
Full out run.
Doesn't the dragon have flight?
Yeah. Well, flight anyways, 150. So I could attack!
Yeah, but you can't use the wings to attack.
No.
When you're flying.
Okay. So...
the dragon can attack. Yes, this is the...
One... The D20 plus 11 hit.
Okay.
And damage 1d8 plus 5. Or plus. Oh, yeah. 1d8 plus 5. Or. Kupo this.
Yeah, now you're out of the bard's range, though, so you can't get that bonus.
No. Okay, no, that is 1d8 plus 4, then. I don't know why I got the extra plus.
Oh, okay, 1d8 plus 4.
11.
Okay.
I actually think that Dubs is out of my range.
One.
Yeah, he is now, because you moved to the other side. Yeah, he is out of your range now.
1d plus 10 for 1. Here's 1 hit. Here's 2 hit. And 1d6 plus 3. 4. So.
Okay. Got it. All right. Top of the order would be Adain.
Adain cleans off his blade and puts it and just stands there.
Got it.
There. Parts on still active, he's deactivating it.
Yep.
Battle's over as far as he's concerned.
Yep.
It's just a slaughter now, he says. And that's and he turns his back.
Got it. That's perfectly good. I like that. Okay. Ixon.
He sees him walking away. What are you doing? There's still fighting going on. Do not walk away.
He's not walking away. He turned his back.
Do not turn your back. We still have enemies. What are you doing?
Are you still talking in your language?
No, this time I'm shouting at him in common so he understands. I'm pissed off.
Dane will say, I'm not going to watch another slaughter.
It's not a slaughter.
You and your dragon can have your blood. You deserve that much. You can have the loot, too.
A guy that likes
and
to steal,
Dane
huh?
will, and Dane will stand there.
Okay.
I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to try and move over there. Except it's obviously I'm not going to full. Well, if I go full out run, I could move 60, right?
Yeah.
So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. So I can't attack, but I'm caught up.
Oh, I can talk like you guys. Ha! Oops, sorry, that wasn't what I wanted to do.
That's smart.
Okay. Turnover.
How do I do the whisper again?
To who? Like you go to every, you see where it says everyone. You unclick everyone and then click on the person you want to whisper to.
Got it. Thank you. All right. Got it.
All right.
Okay. Mr. Dubs, you're up.
Yep. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, okay.
There you go. It is now the bandit's turn, and the bandit drops to his knees. Please don't eat me!
And Dane will sigh quietly and say, it's just a slot. I told you to run. No. And then he just trails off.
The dragon will actually growl, why should I? You wanted my scales.
And, you know, there's this puddle of water underneath him now.
I can't do it. It's not my turn. I have to wait.
Actually, it is actually Young One's turn. Well, unless Ray wants to do something.
Dan offers to buy Delvin a drink. In the next town.
Ray?
Ray. Okay.
Yeah, I had my mic up, sorry.
Okay. Yeah, it's technically your turn, but really there isn't much for you to do.
Yeah, and David's offering your character a drink.
Yeah, I heard that.
In the next town.
Okay. Alright. Then it's Young One's turn.
Curses. I will let you go. Curses be to you if I hear of you hunting another dragon.
No dragon! No.
Next time I will not be so lenient. Okay. I shall move off to the side.
Okay. Alright, combat is over at this point in time then.
And Dan will actually turn his head and say, I didn't know you were capable of mercy.
Can't hear you.
He's waved down there, but yeah, okay. All right. Guys, that was good. We finally got past all of the problems. We got through the first encounter. It is... Of course, why... No.
Whatever time...
Of course, Young One can't actually talk, projecting the voice into the heads.
Right, I know, because he talks telepathically.
Yeah.
But everybody hears it, so it's okay. All right. Okay, all that was worth 2,000 experience points for you, gentlemen.
2,000 XP. I think. Oh! 2,000!
Sorry. 2,000.
I'm 2,000 more short.
Alright. Thank you, guys. It is 10 my time, which means it's midnight East Coast.
See if that extra stuff.
So.
Yes, you did. Okay. How much EXP should we have, Dave?
Oh.
as far as I know, 33,700.
Yep.
Okay.
All right. Thanks, guys. And sorry for all of the fact that I didn't run this for, you know, however many weeks and all that other crap. This helped me out a little bit. I'll be very honest with you. These last few weeks have been such a mental strain on me. I'm glad that I've actually been able to get into getting excited about doing game mastering again. So, thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
Don't worry about that. What was Ron trying to cast on?
Not trying.
He did succeed, but what it is, he found the spell the other day, and it's like, can I get this? I'm like, yeah, you can.
No, I had it, but I just brought it to Dave's notice.
Yeah. It gives it's called negative reaction. It gives you it gives the person it's cast on a minus 10 on any diplomacy or bluff check. So your 23 went to a 13 is what happened. Yeah, what in game effect what happened, and this is why doing it once is fine. I wouldn't constantly be doing it because the thing is that when he starts getting more levels in Bard, he gets stuff that actually helps the party, but
this
was the one tease that you get.
I might do it in bars or something, but
yeah that's where you really want to do it. The actual game effect that it gave is that all of the bandits would have been last in initiative in the combat. That's the game effect that it didn't. So they ended up with actual initiative rolls. They didn't. If it would have been the original roll, they wouldn't have had initiative rolls because they would have been flat footed. So
yeah, really hurt the party in the long term.
Well, I mean, it could. It won't, though. But
no, all right. This was the only time I would most likely use it.
Dan as a character.
Dan as the character doesn't know what he got. He knows he got cast on because it was a will save. He knows he was cast on, but he doesn't know what. But that, you know.
He's not gonna say anything.
It only lasts six rounds, too, by the way. It only lasts one round per... It's over with in six... In six
one round plus level.
One per... Yeah, so seven rounds. It's been gone in seven rounds. So.
Depending on what happens.
Yeah, it could have a game effect. Yes, it could. All right. Thanks, guys, again. I'm going to stop the cast.
Okay, so am I. Thank you, everybody, for keeping it family-friendly.
I'm the one that broke the rules this time, which is sad. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, everybody, for watching. This is Dark Sage Ron, the Relaxed Gamer, saying, like always, save now, save often. I will see you.